Hello everyone and welcome to Van Tech Corner. In this video, let's take a look at the power consumption of the NanoPi R6C in different states such as idle, full load and without the NVMe SSD. At the same time, we will also check out the device maximum 1 to LAN throughput in OpenSpeedTest and iPerf 3. And finally, there will be the OpenVPN and Wireguard VPN throughput test. For the test, I use the Raspberry Pi official power supply. It is a high quality PSU with a USB Type-C connector rated at 5.1 V and 3A. Powering on the NanoPi R6C with no Ethernet cable connected, the power consumption goes up to 2.3 W. After the device is fully booted, the power consumption goes back to 1 watt. After I connected an Ethernet cable to the 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet LAN port, the power consumption goes up to 1.7 watt. Continue to connect the Ethernet cable to the 1 Gigabit LAN port, the power consumption is now 1.9 watt. I will shut down the device to install the NVMe SSD. It is the 16GB Intel Optane PCIe SSD, small but enough for the test. We can see that the power consumption increased by 1 watt after the NVMe SSD is connected. The power consumption is now 2.8 watt with the M.2 connectors and the two network ports fully connected. Let's move on with the throughput test. With a simple PPPoE speed test, the power consumption is 3.5 watt when the download speed is at 940 Mbps. For upload, the speed is lower, it is 450 Mbps while the power raw is at 3.3 to 3.4 watt. That will be the maximum 1 to LAN throughput since the one port is only 1 Gigabit Ethernet. Now, I will do a LAN-to-LAN throughput test. The iPerf 3 server is running on the R6C and the iPerf 3 client is running on my PC. The PC is connected to the R6C with a 2.5 Gigabit link speed. With the iPerf 3 test running in normal mode, the power consumption is 5 watt with 2.36 Gigabit per second throughput. Running the iPerf 3 test in reverse mode, the power raw is only 4 watt. Let's see how is the performance of the R6C with OpenVPN. Unfortunately, the result with OpenSpeedTest is not really promising. We only have 320 Mbps download and 240 Mbps upload with the power raw at around 3.2 watt. However, running the test with iPerf 3 and parallel stream, the throughput goes up to 448 Mbps. Things are getting better with Wireguard VPN. Running the test with OpenSpeedTest, I got 940 Mbps download with 4.5 watts of power consumption and 800 Mbps with 4.4 watts. For iPerf 3, the throughput is 880 Mbps. Alright, so that will be all for the test. Some of you asked me why the NanoPi R6C is having 1 Gigabit LAN port instead of a 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet LAN port. Well, to be frank, it is up to the manufacturer planning and decision on their device. From my opinion, since the R6S is too powerful with two 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet ports which can be used at a router, the R6C is for all the applications and OS, such as Android, Ubuntu, Mail servers, a Docker server and things like that. So that is all for this video. Thanks for watching and see you all in the next one.